When I was in my late teens, there was a neighbor who lived three doors down, and I recall he had problems with drugs. When I was leaving to come to the US, I remember that he had recovered. And then 2 years later, he was found on the beach and had passed away as a result of overdose. It's something that really impacted me. That got me very curious about what drugs are doing to the brain. So I'm a neuroscientist and I study cocaine addiction. We are very focused on a few genes that we know increases the risk for individuals to get addicted. And this is something new and novel that nobody has seen before. We can then go and develop medications that can then eventually help patients. It really takes teamwork and togetherness, which is what I have in my lab. They're troubleshooting with me, and that's honestly a lot of fun. And that's what I enjoy most about being at Weill Cornell Medicine.
I see that a lot of the cells that are expressing this virus are also expressing tyrosine.
We're always thinking about that individual who is addicted and how can we help